3.5 years later, what's been the effect of Act 10 on local schools and local government, Senator?
Well, we're all, every place that I go, you can see the financial crunches on local government. In Racine, there's just back and forth now with firefighters and police officers and trying to figure out how to make those municipal budgets work. And school districts, you see the same thing, that extreme tightening. And where it really hurts, I think, is on low modest income kids and folks who have disabilities and folks who need special help. And the squeeze on school district budgets is especially, I think, going to show up in those areas. If you have young people that come to school ready to learn perfectly and have parents who are all there and really giving them lots and lots of help, they can overcome some lack of opportunity in a public school system. But some children aren't in that situation, so I think about those kids.
A follow-up question on Act 10. Would repeal of Act 10 be a top priority of you and Governor Burke?
I think that, you know, if you listen to Mary Burke's comments on Act 10, she has distinguished between asking public employees to pay a fair share of their health care and their retirement, which she believes is acceptable. Mm-hmm. At the levels that it goes on right now, maybe not, but it basically acceptable. But then there's the other part of Act 10, which has really taken a hammer against the, I would say, human dignity. The whole notion that you're going to pull well-earned bargaining rights away from people who have developed those over generations, but certainly over a long period of time, to take that voice of public employees and say we're going to muffle that voice is just going in the wrong direction. Scott Walker did not need to do that. I mean, well, number one, it was a budget adjustment bill. He shouldn't have moved as fast as he did. But he certainly didn't need to go after the unions. You know, that's right-wing ideology think tank stuff. And that wasn't something that people were calling for, as you recall. It wasn't mentioned in the campaigns ahead of time. We're going to try to strip people of bargaining rights, you know. But I think that that's a very important function. I think that government and schools operate better when you get the full voice of the employees involved there. And you get people with a more positive attitude. I really want to contribute 100% to what we're doing here, and I'm not squashed. My voice is not muffled.
Well, I think the way we saw the deficit in 2011 is unique to our period in time and also some of the struggles we were having coming out of a very deep recession. You remember Act 10 was our repair bill there, and Act 10 made some unique changes that allowed Wisconsin to become the only fully funded pension system in America. Now, it's not the only reason, but it's one of those key pieces which allows our administration to honestly make a promise to taxpayers and job creators that we're not coming after your bottom line to pay for promises made by politicians in the past. We're fully funded in our pension system. And so that hard work, that heavy lifting has been done, and it has been done by all the taxpayers and families of this state, and has now saved Wisconsin taxpayers, between state and local governments, about $3 billion. That's a huge amount of money. So moving forward, I think in the 15 to 17 budget, we're going to be A, looking for efficiencies, and we've already asked our cabinet secretaries to take a deep look at what their real mission statements are. And if they're freestyling a little bit somewhere, perhaps it's time to take a look at their core mission and develop a budget based on that. And then also, we know that we're going to continue to grow as a state. As more people get good jobs, and we know 100,000 plus of them have over the last 3.5 years, and as people take those 76,000 open jobs that we have available on jobcenterofwisconsin.com, we're going to have more taxpayers. We're going to grow our tax base. We're going to end up having more revenue come into government.